Sexual violence is any sexual act or attempt to obtain a sexual act by violence or coercion, acts to traffic a person, or acts directed against a person in sexuality, regardless of the relationship to the victim. When 15-year-old Jen Agaba, not real names, lost her father to a strange disease she doesn't remember, her life was shattered as she was forced to stay with her poor grandmother in Chiruhura district, who barely provided enough to eat.
My grandmother was not around, and Tyson told me that it would be better to have sex with him. And I first refused it, and he said, no, I will not make it to the end. And the sad one, she told me, I will give you money, and I accepted.
Being young, none of them bothered to know the HIV status of the other or even using a condom, and the end result was an unwanted pregnancy, which the boy denied responsibility.
My grandmother took me in the hospital. The first time they told me that it's malaria, and they gave me medicine, but the stomach continued paining me. And then we changed the hospital and went in the other one, and they found me in a blood.
Jen's misery had just started. This was even worsened by her bickering uncles, who had sworn never to admit any girl who gets pregnant before marriage. Jen was forced to leave home only to end up at Wakisa Ministries, an information and counseling facility for girls and their families facing unwanted pregnancies.
Here when I came, I told the counselor my story, and she counseled me, and I feel comfortable here. I was still new when I was still fearing, and when she counseled me, I start feeling the presence and comfortable at work.
It is a holistic kind of approach. You care for their physical, spiritual, emotional, psychological, because when they come in, they're sent away from home. If they're not sent away from home, they are rejected. Even when they're still in the home, nobody wants to talk to them.
Vivian Chito, who has been at this facility for the last 14 years, says they have been able to admit over 1,500 girls.
This is only a drop in the ocean, my dear. I mean, Wakisa Ministry is just can't keep 30 girls at any one time. But the need is great, and we get girls from the north, from the south, from the east and west of our country, and the central area. We just say no way. As you walked in, there were three girls brought in from Gomba to be admitted here.
The Uganda Violence Against Children Survey report findings released in August 2018 shows that one in three young women have experienced sexual abuse during their childhood, and this is usually inflicted on them by people close to them. So what should be done to curb the situation?
We've come up with a national action plan to respond to violence against children. That's one. Two, we have a strategy to address issues of adolescent pregnancy and child marriages. And that's where I depart from some of these concepts. I'm trying to fight, and my PS is leading the battle. We want to fight the concept called child marriage. Because if you say child marriage, you are like saying it's another type of marriage. Like you say, I'm married in church.
Sexual violence encompasses sexual abuse and exploitation of children, including forced sex, erotic touches such as grabbing or fondling of the child, harassment, threats and tricks directed towards a child in exchange for sex. The Uganda Violence Against Children Survey Report findings indicate that boys too continue to face sexual violence. UNICEF, in partnership with the Ministry of Gender, Labour and Social Development, launched a toll-free helpline that members of the public can use to report forms of violence and abuse against children, and the toll-free number is 116, or else one can send us on 8338 if they have a story. Sexual violence is one of the most prevalent forms of violence against children in the country, and experts do believe that the country continue to lose a lot in terms of children dropping out of school
others committing suicide. It is therefore upon us to change the way how children feel so as to help them speak out when such things happen in society. I'm Denis Woniala for Urban TV.